Okay, let's make something creative in Photoshop. First of all, just double click on this window. Now you have an open window, or after some open window, I think. Then after that, just click on some images to open that. I have chosen this image of this girl, and again the image of a horse, and I required an image of this landscape. Now just click open. So you have got all these three images. Now what you have to do, you have to just select this horse. Select this girl, make a hybrid character, and then place it into part of this environment. So that's all what we want to do. Now let's start selecting this image. First of all, let's make a new composition file, just make a composition size that is around full HD. Full HD, it's around 1920 by 1080. So that would be around like something like this, and then click OK. Okay. Now, first of all, select this background image, drag it and place it into this image. Close this. I don't require this image. Now I have a proper background with a proper size. Press Ctrl T for the transform, or just click here to show transform control and just scale it as per your requirement. Just scale it as much as you wanted, okay, like this. I required some base so that I can place my horse and this hybrid character into this. So now press enter. Okay, now make a selection of this girl and just select it and cut it as much as your requirement. So just go to this pen tool. In this pen tool, just maximize this window, minimize this one, Control plus, just zoom it. And then start selecting the body part of this girl. Okay. Okay. Now after that, just use this direct selection tool. And if there is some issue in selection, you have an option to rearrange or remodify it as per your requirement. You can just rearrange and remodify from wherever you require it. Just check it again. Is everything is okay? Yes. Now every selection, every part is like clear for me. Okay. Now again go to the selection, make it as a selection, just convert this pen tool into a selection and go to this edit and copy it. Now again go to your image, that is your background image, and edit and just paste it. So you got a girl, in particular this image. Okay, now just close it. I don't require this one. Close it. Now you have an option of like horse. Again make a selection of this horse in the same way that you have make a selection of that girl. Similarly, you can make a selection of this horse also. Let's start with the pen tool. Make a selection. Okay, now finally I've made a selection. Just go to the direct selection tool and just click here and modify the things wherever it required. Just check the overall selection aspect once again, and then you found that now the things have been okay, a bit okay, like this. Finally, again go to this selection, convert to selection. Okay, now zoom out. Again, edit, go to this copy, go to this area, and again paste it. So I've got a horse on this side and a girl. Now close this horse. I don't require this. You have just noticed that I didn't select the head of the horse in a proper way and the lower legs of this girl. So what I can do, like I can just place this horse into this area. Now Ctrl plus, zoom it, make it a bit large, place it into this direction and right click and go to this canvas size. You can increase the height of this area by using the canvas size. Just check the height, that is 38 centimeter. Let's make it 45. Okay, and just click OK. So what you got, like control minus, you got this background a bit larger on the upper side. Okay, so in this way you can just increase the area of your document without stretching your images and all. So now again go to this girl image, scale it and just place it in the way that it would be on the head area of this horse, like this. And just rename the layers. Like first of all make it as a background, BACKGROUND, make it as a girl, GIRL girl, rename this as a horse, HORSE, horse. Okay, now move this, the layer of this girl on the horse, like this, and just scale it as per the proportion, whatever you required. You can just change it as per the proportion, like this. Okay, see the curve style of this horse would go like this, and just merge into the curve of this girl. Okay, and just imagine that the legs, these legs are the legs of the girl. Okay, now again scale it a bit, make it a bit small. Now you have got a nice background effect of this girl, like this. What you can do, select this horse, go to this eraser, and just erase this, the area of this head you don't require. Okay, just erase this and this way. Similarly make it a bit hard like this, make it a bit hard like this. Okay, and just make the neck a bit straight in this way. So you are erasing the part of the horse, that's why it won't affect on the part of the girl. Now again go to the control plus, go to this girl area, and what you have to do, you have to just like again select the eraser, now you have got a nice blend between the horse and a girl. Now what I have to do, I have to just add this, the color of this image of this horse into this girl. Okay, auto select, image adjustment, gradient ramp, click here, click here. Now select a brown area like this, again this black would become, make it a bit black, brown, make it a bit brown, and white, just increase the intensity of this white like this. Okay, make it more brown, white, add a bit orange like this. So in this way you can just increase the color of this image in this way. Okay, so when you click OK, so without preview it looked like this, with preview it looked like this. So I've got a nice color of this image into this. Now the image has a bit red effect and this image doesn't have a red effect. So what you have to do, you have to first of all just press control plus and go to this smudge tool or eraser tool. First of all go to this eraser, remove this white area into this. What you have to do, you have to just add the hardness and just cut this white area from this, white area from this. If there is any other white area, just remove this using white, using eraser. Okay, like this. Now just lock this layer, go to the smudge and just mix it with the white areas. Okay, so in this way you can just remove this effect into this way. Now again go to this brush. You have some good brushes like this which can be used to smudging and make a good hair. So these brushes are used to make some good nice kind of an hair effect. Like this. So just check the strength area. Increase the strength up to like 98. So in this way I have chosen some different type of brushes and just applied to make such kind of nice effect with the help of like a smudge. Smudge is a very kind of a good tool to make hairs and other things look good. Now control minus, you have got a nice hairstyle and all. Again go to image adjustment, go to like hue saturation and just change the color to bit red effect, so that you have a nice reddish kind of a tone, and just desaturate the overall image so that it can easily incorporate with this. Now press OK. So you have got a nice composition, like control minus, you have got a nice composition of the girl and a horse like this. Now again go to the background, just make a copy of this by making a duplicate layer and just click on the OK. Now image adjustment, we have an option called hue saturation. Just go to the colorize option and you can just colorize the image as per your requirement. Okay, make it a bit dark. Now go to this like blending mode. You can just mix this image with the background so that you can get a nice dark and kind of an effect into this image. Okay, now if you reduce the opacity you can get the same effect like this. Now again make a new layer. Now go to the brush, select grasses. You have a very good kind of grasses. Take a color that is around green. Now take the background color, it would be like more darker green like this. Okay, now on this layer just make some grasses like this. So this is the area where you can make a nice grass effect for the far, the area which is more away from the camera. Make a bit small grasses like this. Okay, the area which is more closer than the camera, just add up grasses like this. Now make some grasses on the layer above this girl so that you can hide the legs in this way. Okay, now again go to image adjustment, go to hue saturation and just change the color of this grass to like a bit yellow. Make it a bit dark like this. Okay, same with the layer below this image. Again go to the hue saturation, just change the grass color to again some more kind of a dark effect like this. Okay, so in this way you have made a nice grass effect. Now what you have to do, you have to just make a copy of this horse and a girl make this copy and just Control E to merge them. Press Control E to merge them, or go to the layer and merge layers. Press Control E. Okay, so I got a nice single image in this way. Now hide the layers, select this particular layer and make a copy of this, like duplicate layer. Go to filter, other, press high pass, and through this high pass you can just give it an effect like this. Or we have another option like filter, embossed. Emboss will give you a nice light kind of an effect. You have to just choose light direction, so that in this way you can add a lighting effect onto your image and click OK. What does this emboss will do for you? Use like a screen or overlay kind of an effect. It will give a nice lighting on the opposite side of the image. Make it a bit sharp like this. Okay, see this, without this, with this, without this, with this. Okay, now in this way you have made a light effect on this. Now make it a bit lighter. Control minus, like this. Go to the topmost layer and again make a copy of this background. Make one more copy of this background. Don't make it a hard light, make it a screen, multiply like this. Image adjustment, again go to the hue saturation, go to this colorize option, add some color like this and make it a bit like orange or yellow like this. Okay, now make it a bit lighter like this. Okay, now what you have to do, you have to just go to the eraser, increase the size of this eraser, make it a bit softer and just erase the side like this. Change the opacity and just move it like this. Remove this also, remove this also. Now the overall image look like this. Okay, now this is the brightest area from where you are getting the light. Now again, just on the top part where I have made one more blank layer, what you have to do, you have to just use the simple brush with the color of like light yellow and make some patches like this, and also make it a bit hard and add a very little bit of small patches like this. Again go to make a screen and make some white patches into this like this as a. Okay, now what you have to do, you have made this patch effect, go to the filter blur and you have an option called zoom blur, motion blur. Now in motion blur, just increase the distance and change the direction to into this direction. Okay, like this, increase the distance, something like this. Okay, make a duplicate, right click, duplicate layer. Okay, right click, duplicate layer. Okay, make it a bit of screen, make it a bit lighter screen. Okay, now merge all the layers, Control E, Control E. So you have got a nice layer like this. Now after that, just right click, there's an option for warp, and through this warp, what you can do, You can just warp this area of light. Like this. Okay. Now again go to the eraser. Increase the size of this eraser. Just erase this. And just erase this also. Okay. And erase a bit of this light onto this character. So that you can get a bit small here. You can get a bit like very less effect onto this character, above this character, so that we can get a feeling that light is coming on the back side of this character also. Again, make one more layer. Go to this brush, click here, and add some more light effect like this. Change the color to white and add a bit white kind of little effects in this. Go to the filter, again add motion blur and press Ctrl Enter, Ctrl D for duplicate, Ctrl D for duplicate, Ctrl D for duplicate. Okay, now again merge and make it a bit lighter effect. Again duplicate this layer once more. I've got much more lighting effect like this. Again go to the eraser, erase whatever you don't want, just erase that part. Okay, so in this way you can just manage the things. If you don't want it, you can add this things like this. So now select this layer, make a copy of this layer by pressing duplicate layer. Okay, image adjustment, just darken this layer using exposure tool. Make a bit dark like this, place it above this embossed layer, use the eraser and erase it. Make one more copy of this layer, put it on the above this layer, make it a bit light. Go to this exposure, increase the light, again erase it from the back side. Blend it. From where you require it. So in this way, you can just make an object like this. Now go to this adjustment layer and click on this color lookup. To this color lookup, you can add some lookup kind of an effect like this for your environment. Make it look like more realistic. And just reduce the opacity of this color lookup. Like this, and add a strip of 2 or 3 strip like this. Again, go to this color lookup and add this like 2 strip or 3 strip effect. Now reduce the intensity of this also. Now make it more cinematic. Make one more layer. Add a black area onto the top by pressing Alt Backspace, or filter, fill, go to the background color, the foreground color, and click OK. And just make a copy and place it a bit like this. Now again make one more layer, add a full black color in it. File, edit, filter, add a foreground black color, or fill black color like this. This is the kind of black color I have filled it. Go to filter, render, add some lens, kind of a lens flare effect in this area. Press OK. Now click here, go to screen, you add a filter like this, reduce the opacity and go to eraser and erase the section from here. Okay, so got a nice lens kind of an effect into this area. Just remove it like this. So this is your final output. Press F, press Tab, Control Plus. This is the final effect you can create using Photoshop. Okay, thank you so much. Thanks a lot.